Hi, my name is Ashley Scher. I'm the founder and CEO of Share Love Fund. Today we are going to do a 10-minute yoga flow for incarcerated women, focusing on our key pose, one of our 45 signature Share Method poses, which is cat-cow. We have the cow and the cat. And we will warm up into that pose and do a little 10-minute yoga flow that focuses a lot on cat-cow. But first, we'll start in our first pose, easy C, which we took a deep dive in our last video. And easy C is where we start a yoga class and where we end it. And it's also what we use for meditation. So please take a comfortable seated position. You can sit as I am. If this is uncomfortable, you can even be in a chair or on a bed, and even standing and sort of modify in that regard. Once you're comfortable, let's take a few centering breaths together. Inhale through the nose and out the nose. If your nose is stuffed up, you can inhale through your mouth or whatever suits you. Let's breathe now together. Breathing in light and love, and exhaling all that doesn't serve you. Breathing in light and love, and exhaling all that doesn't serve you. Now let's just take a moment to rainbow our arms from side to side, really getting a nice stretch, reviewing what we did in the last video. Inhaling the arms up, exhale, leaning forward, walking the hands to one side, really feeling this side body stretch, holding it for a minute to really experience the benefits. It takes time to stretch, and sometimes we need to hold it. Inhaling the arms back up, exhaling forward fold, and walking the hands to the other side and holding this stretch for a minute. Coming back up. Then now I have a little competition for the camera. August, come here. So now we will do cat-cow, and I have a little assistant here. So it goes to show we can't always control our environment, but we have to go with the flow. That's what yoga teaches us. So cat-cow is on our knees and like a table. Knees hip-width apart. Wrists under the shoulders, and cow pose is bending the spine, pulling your belly button down, chin up to the sky, and cat is the opposite way, imagining a string to the top of your back, pulling it up. So now let's take some time doing these cat-cows. You can do it at your own pace, but make sure to use your breath. So as you exhale, you can pull up. As you inhale, you can pull in. So try to keep your head straight. So if you're looking at your tablet, then you can move so that your alignment is straight while you look at your tablet. I'll demonstrate to the side. So using your own breath, finding your own rhythm of your breath, we're just going to do some cat-cows here. I have my trusty timer so I can keep these to 10 minutes so they can properly transfer to the database so that we can send these videos to incarcerated women so that they can help themselves while learning about yoga. It's all the answers you have are already inside of you, but sometimes it's nice to know that people care and to give some extra tools for your tool belt. So now this is what I call around the world. So we can be in this cat-cow type position, but really move our body around in a circle, trying to stick one hip out and see if that feels like a stretch, and stick the other hip out and see if that feels like a stretch. In cat-cow, you can also kind of lean forward and back. Forward and back. So here I invite you to take your own pace to kind of move around, shimmy around, try to stretch those nooks and crannies in cat-cow. When you feel ready, we'll just do some regular cat-cows. And with a big inhale, bring your back, one of your feet back, and we'll get a nice hamstring stretch here. So I have my toes curled under, and I will move my hat so we can see better. And I'm just leaning back on it to get a nice hamstring stretch. While I'm doing this, I'm engaging my core. Oopsie daisies. I guess I'm not engaging it enough because I fell over. But I'm engaging my core, and believe it or not, but that's exercise. So we're stretching the back of our leg and building strength in our core. If this feels uncomfortable on your wrist, because we've spent some time on your wrist, you can come down to your forearms. Just be careful not to strain your neck, so you can shake your neck out so it's not strained. When you feel comfortable, you can bring your right knee back in and stick your left leg out. Again, toes curled under, and we'll do this hamstring stretch. Again, if your wrists feel like you've spent too much time on them, you can come down. From this hamstring stretch, we're going to build a little strength, lifting up our back leg, lifting up the opposite arm, keeping our head straight, and holding this for 5 breaths. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bringing it down, stretching out our other back foot, picking it up, engaging our core for 5 breaths. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Coming back down, now we're going to do a little exercise here. We bring our elbow to touch our opposite knee and stretch it out. Bring it in and contract, stretch it out. 3, 4, 5. Again, you can do this at your own pace. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice, long, and strong. Bring it back in. Let's do it on the other side. Stretch it out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Long and strong. We'll come back to downward puppy. It's where our tush is up, our arms are in front of us. We stretch out a little bit. you can come back down to child's pose. From child's pose, come to our seated position, Sukhasana, easy seat, where it all starts and ends. And this concludes our 10-minute workout, highlighting our pose, cat-cow. Namaste. May the light in me be the light in you. Have a blessed day.